Guys, it's the second game of this Seed Story Cup Day 2. As you say it in chat, like, bring AK Wonder back, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, so the admin told me to cast again. This time with Terrence, yeah. Finalist in DreamHack Austin.
Yeah.
And you're like really famous right now in the scene, so you have to be casting with me here. We're going to see a really fun match because Jackie Chan and Hotform are, yeah, they are testing.
Just a test game,
yeah,
so
that's the banned classes. So Hotform has Mage, Warlock, Warrior, and his Rogue banned.
Yeah. And Jackie has Druid, Mage, Shaman, and unfortunately his Paladin got banned. One of the only Paladins that we've seen in this tournament.
Yeah.
But we're not gonna be able to see it this game.
Jackie-chan, RIP Paladin. But it's fine. Yeah. Anyway, we don't know about Jackie-chan's mage because I wasn't watching all the games yesterday. And I know Hotform's mage.
Tempo mage, of course.
It's a tempo mage, but it's just insane tempo mage because he won like 3-0 all his games yesterday. So awesome. Yeah, you can go, guys. So yeah, they are starting right now. I believe Hotform is not gonna start with Mage because it's like his main deck, his best deck. So he wants like to keep it hidden till.
Yeah, he decides to start with Zoo, and Jackie Chan started with the Shaman.
So we can say if it's not Conceit Shaman, which is. Concede Shaman. We see the Jackie Chan's Mulligan. He has Doomsayer, which is really good. Yes. Doomsayer plus Ancestral Spirit is just a really good combo because you have two.
14 health to get through.
And but then next turn, you're going to play Hearth Elemental. I guess I keep all this hand. What do you think?
I just keep the Doomsayer.
Oh, no.
Like, you really want to play it on two against Zoo, so.
You sure?
Most of the time, it doesn't get
turn
too
four,
punished.
Zoo is going to have a 3-2, a 2-2, and a 2-4.
Yeah.
So it's going to be seven damage. You play Doomsayer Ancestral, and then you are going to have 14 HP on board, and you are going to clean the board, and you are going to win the tempo because he will not play anything on turn 4.
Yeah, but like, you
That's
also...
That's huge!
Like...
Ancestral plus Doomsayer is huge! But yeah. It's fine, yeah. I believe. I think Doomsayer and turn 2 is just good. But you know, you just play a minion with Death Rattle. He can't right now, okay? But it's not that huge. Look at this. On turn 3, you're going to play Forbidden, 2 minions, whatever.
He probably plays Doomsayer because he has a 7-7 in hand.
So Doomsayer again? Then 7-7?
Yeah. Got the Storm after that.
Yeah, seems
a
really good start.
Storm after that, yeah.
Like seems a really good start, but I have to say that this is not like a race. You have to like manage your resources.
Yeah, this isn't the typical like game plan of this kind of Shaman.
Yeah.
You don't really want to just like 7-7 just and smash face, but his hand kind of likes that route.
It's never a bad idea to have a 7-7 on an empty board, but I don't know, maybe just like with Argus and the Void Walkers and stuff.
Yeah, but he'll only be on like 4 mana, so the Argus isn't that big of a deal. You have the Lightning Storm Lava Shell combo.
Mm-hmm.
I like it with this hand. Just
this Murloc.
Just go in with the 7-7.
Yeah,
your hand kind of is going in that direction, so I like just.
But also, this deck is just like a new deck and in a new meta. So people may not know about the Doomsayer plus Ancestral.
Yeah.
Like he may not think about it. He may think about the 7-8 plus Ancestral as a good combo. But against aggro, the 0-7 plus Ancestral is just insane for me.
That's so unfortunate for Hotform. Both Doomsayers gone. Now he gets the Crazed Alchemist. And Lightning Storm just gonna clear the board.
It's just a good
face.
Yeah. Turn 3. You have it. Next turn, you're gonna play another 7-7.
Yep.
Is this like a new deck, like with a new idea? Because this is gonna be. I mean, next turn is not only 7-7, like, you can play the
Lava Shock as well.
Lava Shock plus the 7-7?
Yep.
And then, yeah, that's a disaster for Hot Form. He had a good hand, but yeah. Jackie-chan had just Doomsayers.
Yeah, Doomsayers
7-7. Too strong, man. Yeah, then it's better to not keep the ancestral... How is it called? The
ancestral
card?
Spirit.
Ancestral Spirit. Yeah. So then it's better to not keep that the ancestral spirit there. I don't think you play Lava Shock here, you just play 7-7.
Yeah, you just
play
second
7-7. Oh, what?
There's Frost Giants in this deck as well.
Why?
Wow.
Ah, yeah, because he wants to, like, hero power a lot, and then for 0 mana, giant, ancestral copy with face, like, manipulators. So you have 1, 2, 3, 6 8/8s.
I mean, that sounds good, but it seems very, very optimistic.
I mean, it's the only idea behind having a giant in the deck, right?
I don't know.
I mean what could you have this?
It is Jackie Chan, so...
Yeah, I know, but do you don't run charge in Shaman's decks.
Yeah.
So it's just because of the combo with Ancestral, something like that. Amazing. Jackie-chan is always like bringing those new cards.
Yeah.
I have to say that Purple was playing Chi Giant in Druid.
Yeah.
But it seems
you can kind of make a lot of sense out of. It's hard to justify the Frost Giant.
In the Shaman deck?
Yeah.
So funny. He's so funny.
So, Hot Form's looking for one of the...
Power Overwhelming?
Yeah, Power Overwhelming, Soulfire. He wants at least one of them, but doesn't manage to get it this time.
Can he remove everything? Something?
He can move one.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is that enough?
Unfortunate.
With the jugglers.
Yeah.
I mean, I think it's enough, right? Because the Shaman is not going to have any damage, like, to finish the zoo. So if you're ahead on board right now, which I think you are.
Yeah, you are for sure.
I don't know. I don't know, man. So here you have to play Hero Power first. No, if you don't roll spells, just bad. So Stormcrack, a choo-choo, Lava Shock, another choo-choo, and the 7 goes to face, or the 5-5. I think the 5-5.
I like playing the Sylvanas and, like, just... Oh, no, you can't.
You
can
now.
You only have 7 mana. Yeah, I guess.
Stormcrack for sure. So maybe you don't hero power.
Shouldn't you totem first?
If you totem first, you need to play Lava Shock.
Yeah, you can still, like, Lava Shock first.
And
like,
Stormcrack, but then you have 7 mana next turn. You can't play Ragnaros, you only can play Sylvanas. I don't know, maybe. Maybe it's correct.
Yeah.
I'm just...
Because it gives you at least... the chance to kill the
5-5. It's just a 25%, and you have 1 mana less next turn. Is it worth it?
Not sure.
Yeah, me neither. Anyway, he played Stormcrack, Lava Shock, Hero Power after, just to have 8 mana crystals next turn, and he went face, which is like, okay, as a zoo, I will not. Ooh, now Finlay is not that bad because you will tap like 1 or 2 more turns, and you can play it after to get a better hero power, like a heal or ping or hunter. But he decided to go for Possessed Beatlegger because he knows that Shaman runs a lot of
AoE,
so he wants to have sticky minions on board all the time. Yeah. An Argus.
Yep.
And go face, I believe. You don't want to trade here. If you didn't. Okay, but if you don't trade,
you
may die.
Lightning Storm can kill you,
Okay, it's fine. Okay, it was too greedy to not trade. But now, if you played Stormcrack and Lava Shock last turn, it was to play Ragnaros this turn. Because Sylvanas doesn't do that much. So just Ragnaros, I believe.
Yeah,
I don't see a way to not play Ragnaros here. Just to get some value immediately. Sylvanas doesn't get value against Zoo at all. The town is going to be played next turn anyway. What?
I have no time for games.
Ah, I see. The Frost Giant its synergies with the hero power, like the same as the things from below. So maybe you can have like crazy turns with things from below and frost giants. I don't know.
I'm still not convinced on the frost giant. I mean, and against like control decks, it might be okay.
Do you like Doomguard here and going all in? Because now the problem is that you discard two of your best cards, and now you put a five attack minion on board. So that means your Sylvanas can get value. I'm not sure about that play.
Lightning Storm could potentially get him back in the game.
Yes. Yeah. Definitely. I think I would prefer to keep playing sticky minions.
Yeah, and then try and use the Dimbato's finisher. Hex
is okay for 0 mana. Well, for 3 mana because you played Farsight. It's fine. Yeah. So you hero power things from below, Hex the 5/7.
Yeah. Farsight in this situation is basically just a free draw card.
Yeah. It's just to cycle your deck. And it allows some combos.
Yeah.
Okay, but now the Shaman is just looking for AoE or healing. Because he runs, he should run at least 2.
Like healing wave, maybe.
Yeah. So you now trade your 1/1, or just he does it. More sticky minions, and I think you go face here. Like maybe you trade with the 1/1 just to not let him trade, but you go face. Yeah, of course.
I like.
two frost giants and a Ragnaros in. Hero power Ragnaros and pray.
Yeah. Get a taunt
you may
totem
die,
and hit one of
or
the
you
two.
May win here.
Taunt totem.
Yeah, taunt totem is okay, but you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. One out of 6 to win. Mm-hmm. 14 cards left for the rogue. Just a 1/1.
Yeah.
Okay, this is not lethal yet.
No,
2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's one
six.
Off.
So
tap for 1 damage or die trying hot form. Your subs are on the chat. Wait. Ooh, no, flame him. No, flame him.
I mean, it is an Argus, so he's not dead.
Yeah, he's not dead, but it is. You don't have a way to town 2/1 attack minions. So, Silva. Well, at least. Well, you can like taunt only the 1/1 with Divine Shield. You deal 1 less damage, but Sylvanas is not gonna get value again.
Yeah.
If he has AoE, you are gonna die anyway. So I think you can like just Argus the Aryan Squire.
Yeah, I actually like that a lot because it doesn't. If he's able to trade the Sylvanas in, that's one less target for Rag to hit, so that it could potentially hit your face.
Hey, he did it!
Very smart play by Hotform to only taunt the 2/2. And the Flame Imp is one less card for. One more card for the Ragnaros to hit, but not playing it allows you to tap to look for direct damage if
healing?
You need to.
Yeah,
healing
he got it. That's huge. That's huge.
Yeah, just play it.
You play it and you play the hero power giant as well.
Yep.
Oh, Yaki-chan, man. This deck. The 1/1 is not that it's not good. Like, the town last turn was crucial.
Yeah, that was huge.
You win easily.
For
14. Hot form is just like, why? My life is so bad.
Double
never lucky.
Frost Giant Shaman is about to be at a zoo.
That's true. He can't play Flame Imp. I think he prefers to tap.
Yeah.
And what do you do here?
4.
Oh, that's good. That's good. Wait. No, I don't see a way to win here.
9, 13.
It's not enough damage, but you don't have good trades. Sylvanas is now getting value. I think you can trade the choo-choo with town into the 1/1. Then you don't attack with anything. You play Gore. No. You play your 1/1 into the Sylvana, so he will steal your 2/3 or your 2/1 with town or your 2/1 without town or your 1/1. And then you Gormok. You can't Gormok. This is a disaster. This is a disaster.
Yeah.
I don't know, man. I'm not sure.
Oh, you're dead this way. You have to kill the...
Okay, you can Gormok. That's something. Yeah, you're alive! You're alive! Yeah, Hotform did the best play here. I couldn't find it, but yeah, never mind. Dead. Rip. Yeah, it's fine. Jackie Chan playing some giants to finish the game. Boom.
Frost Giant finished the game. It must be good in the deck.
I'm not sure, but I think I can see this deck working well against control.
Yeah.
But Bok Creeper is better against Zoo and aggro decks.
Yeah,
right?
For sure.
Because it has taunt. It's a 6/8 instead of a 8/8. But yeah, this deck is just too good against control because just the
just
combo.
Too many threats.
Yeah, just hero power combo, boom, boom. Yeah, it's fine. Jackie Chan 1-0 with the Conceit Shaman Frost Giant deck. And now Hotform, he believes on his Tempo Mage. I played only one time Tempo Mage against Conceit Shaman, and I lost, obviously. Yes. But I felt like Tempo Mage is just good because like you can threat with direct damage to the face all the time, and you don't have to overextend on board.
Yeah.
Because there are fireballs and frostballs. You don't have to play big minions or something. I didn't see a single hex in Jackie Chan's deck. We saw one.
Yeah, we did.
Again, Doomsire, he doesn't need it. He should know that Hotform is playing Tempo Mage.
If Hotform, he knows Hotform doesn't have a 1 or 2 drop, so.
Uh huh.
I mean, Jackie Chan. No, yeah, never mind.
Yeah, no. What do you do against the Dacolyte? It's gonna get value, real value.
Yeah.
You don't want to.
And
play
you don't
Storm,
really
want
a Stormcrack. You'd rather use that on a Flamewaker,
yes.
But you also don't want him to get 2 draws out of the Acolyte, 3 draws out of the Acolyte, because he could bring it as well.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Is he gonna play Doomsayer?
Yeah.
So, what now? Apprentice? Prospool? Yeah, you can't, actually. Oh, there is not a way to kill the Doomsayer. It was?
I don't think it's worth it, even if there was.
So you prefer like to ping your Acolyte and to let him die?
Yeah.
Okay, makes sense.
Jackie gets initiative. We know that he plays the 7/7s,
uh-huh.
The thing from below.
Uh-huh.
But you should be able to deal with it. You have the Frostbolt. Stop it for a turn, maybe. But it's thing from below, not a 7/7.
I think you can play Frostbolt here and something else. Because Azur Rake, I prefer to save Azur Rake for the Arcane Blast.
Yeah.
Or just
Frostbolt Flamebreaker seems fine.
Yeah.
Flamebreaker is very likely to get Stormcracked.
Oh, wow.
Nice. Won both 50-50s. Yeah, so this turn is just Stormcrack, Hero Power.
I mean, Hero Power is always good when you have Frost Giants in your deck, so...
Yeah.
Just play as many hero powers as you can, and that's it. Yeah, elemental.
Yeah,
you can play
a two drop,
whatever. And now I think the shaman is like at the point where you can't play AoE because it's not optimal. Hex sounds like bad, but you have to play it. So I guess Hex hero power again?
Hex isn't the worst in Tempo Mage. Like, the biggest Hex target is Ragnaros.
Mm-hmm.
Then after that, all the rest are okay. Like, Flamebreaker is an okay Hex target, I guess.
Yeah.
Water Elemental, I don't know. Maybe, but the Ragnaros is the main one.
If you run the 6 mana, 5,
oh,
5.
Faceless Summoner?
Yeah.
Yeah.
There is a swing, when you have a Sorcerer's Apprentice on board, there is always a swingy turn where you can play everything, or maybe you don't want to play everything, just Arcane Intellect and pass turn.
Yeah, just Arcane Intellect again.
Oh, Arcane Missiles, why? Because it's free? So ping and go face. Yeah, he decided just to play only one spell. He could choose like between Arcane Intellect and Trait, or missiles and hero power and Trait, or hero power or whatever.
Yeah.
And now what? Another hero power?
Yeah, so basically he used the Arcane Missiles to push 3 damage potentially.
Tempo play?
Yep. He'll get to develop the Frost Giant into an empty board.
Well, he wants to play Sea Giant plus Ancestral Spirit next turn for 8 damage.
A lot of Tempo Mages aren't playing Polymorph, so Frost Giant will...
Well, you can run a Polymorph in the Tempo...
Yeah.
In the Tempo Mage, but... I don't know. I don't think Hotform plays Polymorph.
No. He has Acolytes in it, he has Torches in it. There's very likely to not be space for Polymorph.
Okay. And now... Oh, look at this damage. This is like...
6, 12, 15... Yeah, 15.
It's 15, right?
And then you have to factor in the spell power and the ping.
No, but you have spell powers. It's 18 damage. It's only 3 off with 10 mana, right? No, you need more than 10 mana. Because it's... Apprentice, it's 2 mana, so 4 mana. That's no. For 10 mana, it's 18 damage, isn't it?
Yeah. No.
But he already played everything, so. He prefers to remove the threat, which is okay.
Yeah, it makes sense. The deck has a lot of healing, has double healing wave. Mm-hmm. And you can't really just leave up a 8-8 hitting you in the face while you're trying to ping for 3 turns.
And also, if you don't kill it, he can Faceless Manipulator.
Yeah. Because you'd have to get 3 pings in, because you have to play the 18 to OTK. Yeah, I like removing.
Now you're playing Acolyte, Ping, Torch.
Yeah.
And maybe Talnos. To draw more?
Yeah, you just need more options. You can't save it for burn at this point. You use most of your burn.
But Hotform is gonna run out of cards only by removing all the threats. Imagine that Jackie Chan plays another threat, like this one.
Yeah.
You're spending all your resources on the minions, and then you will run into fatigue.
Let's see. How much?
You can check it.
Yeah.
12?
12 cards left in
with
deck.
One torch, no, one 6 mana, 3 damage coming from torch, how it's called, the card?
Roaring Torch.
Yeah. Do you have to deal again with this, this big
that's
minion?
That's 14 damage of minion.
That's the problem. So you are an intellect, you ping your acolyte, you run, you... Ah, another torch. Mirror Image is huge because now it has only one card.
I think both Lightning Storms have been used.
Yeah, but not the Elemental Destructions.
Have we seen an Elemental Destruction yet?
No.
There probably is, but...
Yeah.
I don't think we've seen one. I think you just start going in.
Mm-hmm. Do you kill the Totem?
Kind of want to hit the face, but...
I mean, it's only 2 damage for Spell Damage Totem.
Hmm. sides against
maybe
it.
Maybe Hotform knows that he's not running elemental destruction that's what I say. Now you face this manipulator, the 7/7, you hero power. Okay, the 7/7 is just killing Ochus right now, but
there's so much damage.
It's gonna be 14 damage soon.
The fireball and the torch are both representing 6 damage with the blood mage and the double mana worm.
I understand. So it's 4 + 4 + +1 + 1 in mana worms.
Yeah.
So it's 5 damage each.
No, it's 3 + 1 from the blood mage +1 from the and then +2 from both of the mana worms. So 6.
Oh, wow. 6 damage each. Yeah. Okay.
Because they're both just fireballs.
Fireballs. Oh,
but
Hex.
One of the mana worms gets
Hex,
so
there.
Now it's 5.
No, Ragnaros is going to be a good draw. He doesn't have it. I don't know if it makes sense to play Water Elemental here to freeze the 7/7s a bit. Now he's starting to go face. I think it's a bit late.
I like it. Just get the guaranteed damage out of
that. That much damage. Well, it's already on 10 HP, and you at least have one more fireball and one more torch. Oh,
even? Well, now with the taunt, but he would have had lethal next turn if there was no answer.
Okay, that's true.
That's
lethal anyway.
Yeah.
You can acolyte. If it's not lethal, you can draw one more card with the acolyte.
You could just draw two looking for the torch or the fireball. Wow. There was 2 and 7.
Yeah. So Hotform seems like to be really good with tempo mage. He knows how when to trade and when to go all in. And Jackie Chan didn't draw any heal, right? Or one?
He drew the Halazeal. And he drew one of the healing waves. Yeah. No.
And the thing is he playing Elemental Destruction?
We haven't seen one. We've only seen Frost Giants. Flaming Faceless.
And he had only like 10 cards or 13 cards left now, right? He may not run Elemental Destruction, which is okay because he's playing a lot of minions, so you can play every card in the Shaman League and in the Shaman deck.
Yeah.
And now it's like Jackie Chan with
Druid and
Mage against Hotform with the Mage right now and also
the Warrior.
Okay, so I think you prefer to go with the mage no matter what.
Yes, you don't want to be.
Because the Druid is just not good against Tempo Mage.
Yeah. If Tempo Mage gets that early start and you don't get the removal for it, then Tempo Mage can just run away with the game.
Okay. So, Mirror Mage.
Yep, Tempo Mage, Mirror Match.
Tempo Mage, Mirror Match, but you never know what Jackie Chan is going to play.
Maybe there's Frost Giants on this too.
Frost Giant here. No, I don't think Frost Giant, but maybe Tisselty is not the mage card.
That's a rogue card.
The 5 mana draw 3 random.
Kabbalah Stone?
Yeah, yes. Kabbalah Stone. This one.
That's a pretty wacky card.
No, but he may play cards like this. Who knows? I'm not sure. But I like both. Hands, like for Hotform, it's easy to remove everything with the Arcane Blast plus cool sorcerers.
Yes.
And for Jackie-chan, it's just a good curve, so you can play your minions and remove whatever is coming.
Mm. What true drop do you like from Jackie?
I think the other one, because you want to save the spell power in case you draw Arcane Blast.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I like saving it for spell power as well.
So here you can Arcane Blast the 3/2 coin. So is he gonna kill? Yeah, that was the play I was thinking about. Killing the 3/2 and playing a minion. Frostball is okay. Oh, now
he's
playing Sorceress
response.
Plus Frostball.
Yep.
Which is better. Someday I'll be just like you. Like his last play was better against this 3/2, because if you save the cool sorcerers, you can't play Frostbolt and the 3-2 in turn 3.
So yeah.
It was actually better. But in general, I don't know if it was better. Now it's a good top deck for Jackie-chan. Otherwise, you had to play the Flamewalker for tempo there. But now it's just the insane curve. You can choose between two Frostballs or a Fireball.
I think you go with the double Frostbolt. Because Mana Worm can get better and Water Mantle will always be a 3-6.
Okay. And now it seems to...
Maybe... Yeah.
Flamewalker...
Maybe Jackie just runs out of cards this game.
Why? Because... I mean, he doesn't need that much cards. It's just play Flamewalker, ping, go slowly till you can play Flamestrike.
Yeah.
And then you can joke or play whatever is coming.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not that necessary like to be fast in the game, to curve perfect. I think with Flamestrike, you can like go slowly. I believe. I'm not sure, actually, but... So here, maybe Fireball, I don't know.
Because I think Azure Drake the Fireball,
seems too weak, Azure Drake. And Water Elemental is just... I don't like it. Water Elemental is weak as well. Maybe you can you have to Fireball. But what do you what do you Fireball here?
The Flame Waker.
Oh, like,
alright, Jackie's on two cards, right? So, the Water Elemental is always 3 damage, but the Flame Waker can do so much damage. Yeah, so I've, like...
Look at this 5-2. Oh, that's old curve.
Alright, so...
I mean, Jackie-chan had the good curve all the time, since the beginning. Turn 1, Vermis. Turn 2, Minion. Turn 3, Minion Spell. Turn 4, Water Elemental. Turn 5,
Flamewaker Ping, right? I think it was Flamewaker Ping.
Flamewaker Ping. Turn 6, Faceless Summoner. So only the only weak turn was the turn 5.
Yeah.
Rip.
So that's 10, 12, 13 damage right now.
It's a lot. I think he can put it on 3. I think
that's 13.
Yeah. The tempo mage doesn't run any heal, so it's just 3 pins. Will you die in 3 turns?
And that's not even enough turn to get to your Yogg to maybe save you.
Yeah, that's true. He's praying for nothing. I guess nothing. Oh,
mirror image.
Yeah, mirror image. Like,
in his mind, that's potentially
good card. Saves him. But
oh no, just dead on board.
Hot form. Yeah, Flamestrike. You win this time. So 2-1 for Jackie-chan. Tempo mage against tempo mage. It's just like the same when you play Sue against Sue. The one who is like with the best curve at the beginning. It's just most likely to win easily.
Hotform's still on this though. He still has Warrior left.
Yeah, of course.
Warrior is a very strong deck that's been getting banned a lot this weekend. There's definitely still a reverse sweep potential from Hotform.
Yeah, of course.
With the Warrior.
Yeah, but also Jackie-chan only has Druid, so Warrior should be okay against Mage and okay against Druid overall. Oh, and it's control at least.
Yeah.
We're seeing.
Not sure if it's C'Thun or control, but
with Gorehole can be either C'Thun or control.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I mean, we see the Jessica as well that also represents C'Thun control, so it's probably not any other kind of wacky warrior.
And then Jackie-chan had Fireball and something else that I didn't see.
He kept the Frostbolt.
It's C'Thun. I love Hot Form from now on. C'Thun is just too strong. C'Thun Warrior is just insanely good. And against Freeze Mage, I'm not sure actually.
Tempo Mage.
I mean, with Firework Axe, you are fine. Yeah. And with Disciple of C'Thun, if you remove like the first 1-2 threats, like the 3-2 and stuff, you may be fine. But I don't know. I think Tempo Mage is favorite in the matchup overall.
I think when you have the War Axe start, then the C'Thun Warrior is favored. Like, pretty much you're gonna out heal them, and as long as their Yogg doesn't do too much, mm-hmm. you should still be fine.
Okay.
Just get to a point where you can't die anymore.
Okay. Cthulhu, Hotform has a good hand anyway. You can play like shield blocks, draw some cards, buff your Cthulhu. Yeah. You have brawl if you need it. I think he's in a good spot, definitely. Yeah. I think he will remove efficiently the elemental, the water elemental with the shield, with shield slam.
Yeah. Has Disciple of Cthulhu for the 3/2s, I think.
You can also play Ravak and go and execute here, but I'm not sure if you want.
I think you'd rather save that for like a Ragnaros, because if he plays down a Ragnaros later, it could shred your armor, and then you have the guaranteed kill with the Ravaging Ghoul, as opposed to having the Shield Slam and maybe not enough armor to use it.
Okay. Now you can not just saw the Shield Slam, so you go for the mirror image. And I think Brawl is just fine here. Why not?
Yeah.
You only have a 25% of... you go Brawl. I think you go Brawl because you have two. What do you think?
I was thinking about... I would have liked to see him just like think about it a little bit more. Just he played the turn really fast, and I started to think about Shield Slam and Disciple. Didn't get too much time to think about it because he just brawled right away, but I don't know. I would have thought about it for a little bit longer.
I think brawl is just too good to pass it here against Tempo Mage. You don't have a lot of good spots to play brawl, and especially when you play two, you don't want to have like two brawls on hand all the time. So yeah, unfortunately, the 2/4 survived, which it was the only one
out of the only one that doesn't die to the axe.
So, but it's fine anyway because you are gonna play Ravak in goal next turn. Yeah. And if he plays the 6 mana drop, he's gonna execute it. So it's fine. It's fine. Even the worst case scenario for Brawl, it was okay.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, I see it now. Like you have two, you don't want to be stuck with both of them. So.
Yeah.
Just go with the brawl.
But we need one more Cthulhu buffer to play a good Twin Emperor Beklar.
Yep.
And that's really huge because Tempo Mage doesn't have a way to deal with the 2/4/6 and turn 7.
Yeah. It doesn't feel good just double fireballing those.
And you don't even have fireballs, so. Just play, Jackie Chan, play it! Swift Rage.
You just have to play the Face of Summoner.
Turn 6, Face of Summoner, go for it. That's so bad! No, Jackie!
He got the Ice Rager last time, too.
Oh, yeah! All the magmas. Oh, no.
Yeah, you.
Disaster. And Hotform was missing the Cthulhu buffer, and now he has it. So next turn, Cthulhu chosen, and Disciple of Cthulhu is going to be played soon. Jackie Chan has a really bad hand right now.
Yeah.
No minions, anything. He just needs Jog, or
Jog has to be big this game.
Yeah. Doom Caller. I think I coined Doom Caller here. Because it's a 6/7/9, or so. How can the mage kill a 7/9?
Yeah, this is one of the matchups where you don't have to rely on playing multiple Cthulhu's. You should be winning after one.
Yeah.
So I definitely like getting just the 7/9 out as a threat.
I think I could have played Doomcaller, Coin Doomcaller there, like pressure.
Yeah.
But it's fine, I mean, 4-2 is okay. I mean, it's easy to kill with ping plus Arcane Blast.
Yeah.
But you wanted to ping the 3-1 as well. Now Arcane Missiles are okay, but you don't have it anymore. Yeah, ping, Arcane Blast. As I say, it's a Tempo Mage here.
I guess he wants value out of the Flame Shark.
That's too risky, man. Doomcaller, go punish. Go punish.
Yeah, definitely Doomcaller.
I think Jackie Chan is like scared about spending resources here.
Yeah, it.
But
doesn't seem too bad. Like you're pretty much saving. You're trading for life.
Mhm.
And you get a little bit more value out of the Flame Shark. It's not too bad, and his hand.
Yeah, that's
it's looking true. Very bad right now, so.
Joke or Riot?
Yep. Just gotta play.
Maybe Azure Drake is fine.
Azure Drake's not enough.
Yeah, it's not enough. Or. Yeah, but Mirror. That Mirror. What? Mirror Rematch?
Yes.
It's okay. I don't know. Arcane Blast the 7-2. You have 6 mana left. And then you play Mirror Image and Water Elemental? Or what? Oh, yeah. Yep. The mouse on the side, because it's just pointing some cards sometimes.
Yeah.
So. Yeah, Arcane Blast. I like playing Arcane Blast and Mirror Image and the Water Elemental. I don't see other play here.
Yeah.
You need to save some damage, I believe. Okay, first release is another play. Yeah, it's fine as well. You start frozen all the board. Oh, the combos. Shield block Emperor, Shield Slam.
Yeah.
Or Gorehole.
Nah,
you Shield Slam.
Yeah, for sure.
Just a good. It's just a good. Well, you get punished by another Flame Strike, maybe.
Flame Strike so you maybe
don't play 40. Taurisan. If you think Jackie Chan is playing two, if you think Jackie Chan is playing two Flame Strike, you don't play Taurisan, right? Just wait.
Yeah. Jackie.
Because it's the only way to lose.
A lot of weak turns.
Yeah, a lot.
Yeah. So no,
but it's just variance, because last turn he had awesome hand against Tempo Mage, so yeah. But now it has a decent turn just by playing Arcane Missiles Mirror Image. Arcane Missiles is gonna deal 6 damage in total.
Oh. Really, 4-1,
please.
The 4-1.
The 4-1, please. Yeah. He got it, so Cthulhu comes Green and the game Tenta ends. Rip in Pepperoncinos. It's a 10-10? Can you check?
Yeah, it's a 10-10.
Okay.
So I just play the Cthulhu first, right?
Well, you have like more than 50% of the chances to kill both Ochus, right? Because it's 10 damage. It's hard to say, but I would say more than 50. Oops.
Yeah, you just kill the Flame Waker.
Yeah. Just what can go wrong here?
Yawks are on.
Oh, that's correct! Oh, that's correct. Please.
No.
Never lucky. Maybe a Frostbolt? Yeah, third Frostbolt? Yeah, GG. Okay.
Yeah.
Jackie Chan lost this game, so Hot Form is 2-2. Now it's gonna be the last match. It's gonna be like Dread against Warrior?
Yep.
Yeah, I like it. I think Hot Form is still favored because, like, I mean, I don't know the way to play the match, but if it's Dread with all the combos,
yeah,
can you fatigue the Dread?
Yeah, you can, but Jackie is playing the Soul of the Forest build, so
this is harder.
Yeah.
Against control is just too good, right?
Yes.
So the way to win for Hot Form is just push for damage? Try to out-curve a Dread? So, I mean, we need a game plan as a Hot Form.
Yes.
Because, like, in a spot like this, if you win, you are in. If you lose, I think you are out of the tournament, or at least of the upper
this
bracket.
This is the second game of the group.
Okay.
So, this is just their first game being played in this group, so...
Okay, if you lose, you lose the best of 5. But you need to find how to win the matchup, right?
Yeah.
So,
I think your game plan kind of develops after seeing your starting hand. Like, with this starting hand, he can't push. So he's going to try and just maybe have multiple board clears and try and use them as efficiently as possible. But with Onyxia, with Soul of the Forest,
okay,
with
okay,
Violet
okay.
Teacher,
we saw Doomcaller and Taurisan.
Yeah.
So we know it's the combo Kazoom Warrior deck where you want to play Brand plus Doomcaller to get two more Kazooms.
Yeah.
Can this deck outvalue the Jackie Chan Druid just by doing the combo and surviving?
Yeah, he has to survive.
That's the hard point?
Yeah.
Okay, so the game plan for Hot Form is going to be like to combo as soon as possible without dying.
Yeah, and Jackie is just kind of going to keep flooding the board, and eventually Hot Form won't have enough answers to it.
Okay.
It's very important that things like Onyxia and Violet Teacher get entered by Ravaging Ghoul instead of a Brawl, because then there's more options for AoE removal.
Mm-hmm. The cards are Starfire, Savage Roar, and Astral Communion.
Yeah.
I think Starfire is okay, but maybe Savage Roar, it's really good because you are going to play Onyxia. You have... I think Jackie Chan plays the 4-mana card that gives Death Rattle to your minions.
Yeah, Soul of the Forest.
Yeah. So I think Savage Roar is just too strong to not have it as a finisher or whatever, because you know the warrior is going to have a lot of mana. But Starfire is just good. Yeah, he chooses Starfire. It's a good card in a control matchup. You deal 5 damage and you draw a card. It can be bad.
I like the Savage Roar as well, but Starfire is definitely not bad.
Mm-hmm. He wanted to draw for 3, so I believe he wants to have like a card that draws another card. I'm not sure. Oh. So he plays Disciple of Kathun and next time he's going to play Ravaging Ghoul and maybe execute. Yeah. I think Innervate Onyxia, the play, but it's going to be so
punished. It can answer very easily, but Jackie doesn't really have other options.
Do you think, like, waiting for something like... No, I don't see a way.
Yeah.
Nah, it's okay. He had to do it, and yeah, if you have Ravaging Ghoul plus Execute, congratulations, man. And now you have to play Starfire on 3-3.
You have to cycle.
Feels bad, man.
You have nothing for next turn either.
Mm-hmm. Boom. I like this animation. Innervate is bad.
Innervate's another dead draw.
Turn 9, you can play your Wild Growth.
He's gonna want a Teacher soon.
Yeah.
So he can, like, Teacher, Wild Growth, excess mana, Soul of the Forest. Nourish is
okay.
Very good.
Nourish
is the
best.
One card you want in the deck.
Yeah.
There's a Whisper, double Whisper the Old Gods too.
So now you play Swipe, and next turn you play Whispers, Innervate, Soul of the Forest.
Yeah.
Boom! Boom, shakalaka. because the second Whisper of the Old Gods is going to be +2/+2. So you will have a full board of 3/3s. But if the 3/3 dies, it's going to summon a choo-choo.
Yep.
Jackie Chan
Brawl
combo
just doesn't even do anything.
Oh, wow.
And the Soul of Forest is just huge.
Man, I mean, I don't think you want to play Ravaging Ghoul Brawl, do you?
I think you kind of have to.
If you do this, and he plays another Whisper of the Old Gods.
Yeah. I mean, he played one already.
You
don't expect him to have the second one.
Hit armor up, firework axe, not hitting, pass. What now? Or you are scared about Savage Roar?
Like, all right. In this situation, if he has the second Wisp, It's worse that you don't clear now, because then there's three threes and then two twos, and Ravaging Ghoul just does nothing.
Okay.
In this situation, Ravaging Ghoul at least has an effect on the board.
Okay. So now Hot Form has to pray for another brawl, because he's not going to have any answer for the second Whisper of the All Gods. Or you can play Fandral just to... Like, Azur Drake plus Fandral and next turn Whisper of the All Gods.
Alright, so the board clears that have been used already is double Ravaging Ghoul and one of the Brawls. If you're Fandral Wisping, the Brawl's good no matter what. And, like, I think it's okay to just Wisp since there's, like, it has to be entered by Brawl. Right? There's no more Ravaging Ghoul.
Okay.
So I don't think it's too bad.
Well, maybe with C'Thun. C'Thun is good against the 1-1s.
Oh, yeah, we're at nine mana right now, so C'Thun is close.
Oh.
But yeah, this Fandral is definitely getting shield slammed.
Yeah. And you can slam... No, I mean, you slam Fire
You slam Fire War Axe the Fandral, and then shield slam the Drake.
Declare is a good card next turn. And you can Disciple of C'Thun the Choo-Choo as well, if you want. Do you?
Yeah. No reason not to. Well, it is an execute activator. What are you looking to execute? I'm not sure if Jackie plays Ancient of War since he's playing double Wisp of the Old Gods and Soul Forest.
But you can take 5 damage with your Fire Axe.
Yeah.
To activate the execute. It's not that.
Yeah, that's fine.
It's not a problem.
So now it's Teacher Wild Growth.
You can play Violet Teacher or you can play Whisper of the Old Gods. You prefer to play +2/+2, right?
Sure.
Okay, yeah. So you Teacher Wild Growth Hero Power?
Yeah, well, we see what we get off the excess mana.
Yeah, but you want to play Hero Power here. Because otherwise he will kill your Teacher for free.
Yeah. Interesting, he decides to go with the Wisp. I guess, actually, going into C'Thun, I think you'd rather... It's interesting.
I mean, Jackie Chan is a druid specialist.
Yeah, he plays a lot of token druid.
Power of the Wild, Savage Roars, everything is good with your 1-1s on board.
Yeah.
Maybe he plays 2 Soul of the Forest as well.
Maybe.
I don't know. But I would have played Teacher there.
Yeah,
for sure.
I would have Teacher.
Because I want to play Hero Power and I want to play excess mana as well. Like, if you play excess mana right now, you are losing 2 1-1s. But if you play with Violet Teacher... So, Mulch is a card that you want to play because you want to push for damage. But if your opponent plays later on C'Thun, you don't have a way to deal with it.
Yeah.
So it's just a hard card to...
it's good card. Pretty good.
So Mulch is a hard card to play in this matchup. Because I know right now he doesn't have C'Thun because otherwise...
Yeah, you definitely would have C'Thun'd into that.
So, but if I play it and he draws C'Thun, that it's going to be like 1 of 16, 1 of 15, 1 of 14. Yeah, that's really good. That's a really good turn. So now you don't need to waste your
mulch.
Your mulch.
I don't think you'd play it either way. Because you just lose C'Thun if you do.
Okay. Shield block. You can trade now. Yeah. You can Hero Power and play Fire Axe. I like to play Fire Axe because if you draw C'Thun, you can finish the minion.
Yeah.
And you know that Jackie Chan is not playing Harrison Jones.
Yeah,
so I don't see a... Well, maybe if you're playing Gorehold, maybe you can like not play your weapon before playing Gorehold, but I'm not sure. Jogsaron in that kind of board is never like that good because
you're never happy playing it on an empty board. You'd rather play it well.
And you have a lot of cards on hand, so there's no point on playing. So you play your choo-choo and your 3-3 here. It's fine. Next turn, you may play Power of the Wild. Shield block is okay. Second brawl is huge.
Yeah.
Now you can like armor up, pass, or fireworks, the 3-3 armor up pass. What do you prefer?
I think so. This board's gonna continuously push damage. Jackie is not gonna do another Power of the Wild play.
I don't like Chislam. I definitely don't like Chislam. It was his only Chislam left.
Yeah.
You don't have C'Thun. You need to play Brawl, like, not soon, but you will play Brawl soon because he has two teachers and he has full hand, full combos. So, why would you spend more resources in a board where you will Brawl?
The thing is, Hot Form, I mean, Jackie doesn't have to commit to the Brawl while having a board that's pushing 9 damage. Well, it would be pushing 6 because I think you do axe into the 3-3. Mm-hmm. So it's pushing 6. You're taking 4 turn because your hero power is saving you 2. And Jackie just never has to commit to the Brawl if he's not getting... I mean, Hot Form just never has to commit to the Brawl if he's never getting pressured.
Jackie-chan is like, what the heck? Yeah. Second Brawl?
I think you would have preferred to just not commit the Power of the Wild as well, because it has to get answered, and then you have the second teacher, so, and there's no more board clears.
Okay.
But that also gets cleared by the C'Thun, but you also have the Molt in that situation, so.
Okay. Yogg-Saron I think I could rather play, this is a warrior mirror now. I think I could rather play Yogg-Saron when my opponent plays a big minion like Doomcaller or C'Thun.
Yeah.
But it's fine, I don't know.
Banish, that's huge.
That's huge. That's so good.
Yeah.
Shrek, what? 1-1. Gang up at 1-1. Gang up, Violet, that's so bad. Oh, yeah. I'm sorry, Jackie-chan. Kabbalist Tome is insanely good. We don't know the secrets. We have to check. He's gonna discard a card, I believe. Oh, he can play the zero mana minion.
The gang up's not that bad.
Play the minion, or you will discard a card.
Yeah, it's a 2/2.
It's a 2/2.
Yeah, oh. Light in the darkness. The paladin spell, the 2 mana.
Discover a minion.
Discover
and
a minion +1.
Okay. Yeah. Can you check the traps?
The traps are. Wait, we have to check from outside. Yeah.
Okay. So the traps are Snipe and Ice Barrier. Okay. So. No. What did I say? Competitive Spirit, sorry. I don't know what happened, but it was Competitive Spirit.
I thought I saw an Ice Barrier. I don't know.
Yeah,
that's
me
weird.
Too. Me too. I'm confused right now. Never mind. I think it was a bug, but I'm not sure. So
yeah.
Druid, full hand. Yogg-Saron again. A lot of cards. Mage cards. Cards like Torch. It's insane against Warrior because you will not fatigue that early.
Jackie only has 4 cards left in deck.
Okay, he doesn't have any Brawl, any. Anything.
Ghoul.
Only C'Thun.
Yep.
The warrior has how many cards left?
9
cards left. So, one out of 9 to draw C'Thun. Do you want to play Doomcaller or you want to wait?
I think you need to C'Thun twice.
To win?
Yeah.
Can you go for a fatigue strategy?
I think Jackie has too many cards in hand.
Yeah. Oh, no. Oh, so we saw Ice Barrier because it was in Druid's card.
Yeah.
It was in a book. Never mind, guys. Emperor.
I assume Hot Form knows that there's a Mulch in Jackie's deck, and I think you just need to be able to C'Thun twice to win. I think the winning line is C'Thun twice.
Yeah, but maybe if you wait, you're gonna die because you're afraid of Savage Roar as well.
symphony of terror begins.
14, 14, 14, 14
is not that big. It was 11, 11 before. I don't know.
Is there still an Ancient Shield Bearer in Hot Form's deck? Because healing 20 can give him a lot of time.
We saw one, right?
I think we only saw one.
So yeah, there is one more on the deck for sure, and it's Cthulhu as well, in 8 cards.
Yeah. He needs to like hit both of them like very soon within the next 2 or 3 cards.
Mm-hmm.
To have a chance, because he's just going to be taking repetitive damage.
And there is the Savage Roar, right?
Yeah.
That's a lot of damage. Let's count. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, plus 3, 10. There is 6 minions, plus 1 hero is 7, 14 yep. plus... What did I say? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 10. It's 24 damage
yep.
right now, this turn. Next turn is going to be even worse.
It's 24, 28, 31 with the... Torch and the swipe.
So definitely, you can't wait for Cthulhu if you don't play Doomcaller. So I think Hotform did the right choice playing. What's that? Master of Ceremonies.
Yeah. Unfortunately for Hotform, it's not a Deathwing.
Yeah.
Deathwing.
Or another Cthulhu.
Or another Cthulhu.
Or Yogg.
Or shift his Eris into Deathwing or Cthulhu.
Oh, yeah. Cthulhu's chosen.
Yeah,
I don't know if you want to play
enough.
Brand here. You just want to play. Is that lethal next turn? I say 24, so now it's one more, three more. It's 27.
11 on board plus 16,
18, 27. 29? No? I believe it's 27, but I'm not sure. Because it's like 11 on board.
Plus the
plus
5.
16.
No, it's yeah, it is 16.
So it's 27.
Yeah, yeah.
Plus Starfire
yeah.
or Torch.
Yeah, either.
Plus Living Roots. It's lethal, guys.
Rip. And Jackie will be going on to the winners match of the group.
If Hotform would have draw into Cthulhu.
Yeah, he needed Cthulhu a lot earlier to be able to.
Yeah, but Jog was insane as well.
Yeah.
In an empty board, you draw cards and then you banish.
Yep. Him
sorry
getting the Yogg
for
back.
Hotform subs, but Jackie Chan is go through. So Jackie Chan boys, congratulations.
Yeah, good luck, man.
They both enjoyed the game, they are laughing, yeah. talking to each other, but Jackie Chan took the game with his
yeah.
with his main deck, we can say.
Yeah, Token Druid, he's been playing that deck a lot on stream. The Soul of the Forest was huge in the game, there just wasn't enough board clears for Hotform to do it, even though he got the good turn with the Ravaging Ghoul execute on the Onyxia,
yeah.
just wasn't enough.
Oh, yeah, I remember. Ravaging Ghoul into execute, yeah, then he played, yeah. But Jackie Chan. The Druid just had a lot of value. Like,
yeah.
all the game. Only 2 or 3 turns till they, till he draw the Nourish.
Yeah.
And then from
yeah, the
from
Nourish
that,
is big too.
Yeah, Power of the Wilds, everything.
Yeah, that's it for now. Next, we'll be seeing Jackie playing in the winners match of this group, so stick around.